into the modern me. Trying to be somebody I'm not, but it's not what I want. Tell me there's another way. Hey, Ashley.
Hey.
So I just want to take a few seconds to sit down with you and ask you a couple questions about your experience at camp. So that way the people at our church could know the things that the Lord has done in your life over the last week, and also get kind of a glimpse of what camp looked like, and also help our students who weren't able to go to camp this year kind of get excited about camp next year. So I'm going to ask you the first question, and we'll get right into it. Okay? Sweet. So tell me about your favorite part of camp and why.
Honestly, my favorite part of camp would have to be the relationships that I made with all of the girls and just being that close to each other for like that long. Like, I know it was only a week, but just the amount of time or the amount of closeness we got to each other in such a short amount of time, really, like, it just made me like feel so almost like protected, but like just to grow closer in our trust with each other. And yeah.
All right, so next question, what do you think it means to follow Christ?
I think that it means to have a relationship with him and to seek him daily and to just give all your worries and anxieties, like we talked about in camp, to give all your fears. And if you're stressed about something, just know that it's in God's hands, and he's got you.
So, next question. How has camp changed how you follow Jesus?
Personally, I think that camp has really shown me how much of a fake Christian I am, just because I was just going through the motions and going to church every day. And it really, I just didn't have that relationship. And now camp really made me realize that I really needed it, and I'm definitely going to worship a little harder and just get that relationship that I need from Jesus.
Awesome. All right, Ashley, so next question. What is something that you learned at camp, and why does that stick out to you?
Something I learned at camp would probably be just that I need to find the right type of friends and just relationships with people who don't want to bring me down or just try to keep that accountability for each other. I feel like personally I'm good at keeping accountability for others, but not myself. So I just really think that I need to find the right type of people in my life.
All right, Ashley, so this is my last question for you, and I'll let you go. I want you to tell me what your favorite Bible verse is. What does it mean to you, and why does it encourage you?
So my favorite Bible verse would probably have to be Matthew 19, verse 26, and it says, Jesus looked at them intently and said, humanly speaking, it is impossible, but with God, everything is possible. And I really think that this verse really just, like, it's always in my head. And anytime I'm, like, stressed or feel, like, just anxious about anything, I just know to give it to God and just know that it is possible, just to leave it to him and it'll all work out.
Hey Ethan, so tell me about your favorite part of Journey Camp.
My favorite part of Journey Camp was probably worship, because it helped me come out of my shell more and it helped me connect with God.
What do you think it means to follow Christ?
To follow Christ, it means to surrender totally on a daily basis and to share the gospel with my friends.
So, how has camp changed how you follow Jesus?
Camp has changed how I follow Jesus because it has made me stronger and more determined to overcome my temptations in life.
All right, so Ethan, what do you think you learned at camp?
At camp on Man Night, I learned the importance of respecting women, protecting them, and seeing them the way God sees them.
So, dude, last question. What is your favorite Bible verse, and what does it mean to you?
My favorite Bible verse is Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. This verse has led me through hard times, and it has helped me overcome temptations.
Hey Maggie, how you doing?
Hey.
All right, so I got a couple questions about camp that I want to ask you, and we'll just get right to it. Does that sound good? All right, cool. So tell me about your favorite part of camp, and why does that stick out to you?
My favorite part of camp was probably worship, because I feel through music. I don't know if that makes sense.
Yeah.
But I just understand music better than other things. And being in that room with everyone singing and feeling through the music at the same time, it helped me think through my own life. And I was able to, like, basically scream out or sing out my emotions through the songs.
All right, so next question. What do you think it means to follow Christ?
I think it means to try your best to do what he wants and to get others to follow him, because you know that that's the best thing for them. But even if you don't always do the right thing, you're still trying.
All right, Maggie, next question. How has camp changed the way you're following Jesus?
Well, before I kind of felt like I had to do it alone, and camp helped me realize that I have all these people around me that are here to help me and fight with me, and so we can follow Jesus together.
All right, Maggie, so next question is this. What is something that you learned at camp, and why does that stick out to you?
Something I learned was that it's okay to not be perfect all the time, and my friends are always here for me, and that they do care about my problems no matter what I think about them.
All right, Maggie, so this is my last question for you, and then I'm going to let you go, okay? So tell me what your favorite Bible verse is, and what does it mean to you, and how does it encourage you?
So Romans 12:21 is my favorite Bible verse. It says, "Don't let evil conquer you, but conquer evil by doing good." This really means a lot to me on a daily basis, because little things can seem very evil at the time, and it's hard not to let them get the best of you. So I just try my best to always face it with a good attitude, and just anyone that's not being nice to me, I'm nice to them, and it's really freeing when you let it.
That's awesome. Well, thank you so much for your time.
Mm-hmm.